Hi, this is Ali, and you're watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss the generative AI capabilities of ChatGPT. Generative AI is technology that can produce various types of content like text, images, audio, data, and other media using generative models. Such models, and with specific reference to large language models, have learned the patterns and structure of natural language to a level that they can not only understand, but also generate content given instructions. Generative capability of ChatGPT is the inverse operation of summarizing, where you provide a small, or in some cases, no piece of text as input, along with some instructions, and you get a larger piece of text as an output. Language models like ChatGPT, which are trained on large volumes of data, can add information by themselves to a smaller piece of text, or their own training data, which is the public internet, to expand or generate new content as per instructions. This concept is best explained by an example. Say you have received a customer email or comment regarding your service. You want to respond to your customer with an automated email generated by ChatGPT. How would you go about doing that? One way of doing that is to instruct ChatGPT to extract sentiment of original email, and based on the sentiment value, you either generate an email thanking the customer for his appreciation of your service, or apologize if customer is angry, and inform him that his complaint is being looked into, and he would receive a response within 7 business days or something. You can instruct ChatGPT to empathize with the customer by adding the relevant part in the response. For example, thank you for appreciating our product, or sorry to hear about the issue you had with our product, with the product name, to make it more personalized response. You can also instruct it to include a certain signature in the email, like customer AI chatbot assistant. Now, ChatGPT would use that information to come up with an email response based on all of these instructions. That would be a full email with all the ingredients, including header, subject, content, signature, etc. And all the information would be generated based on input from the original user input email. Using similar techniques, you can generate letters of resignation, CVs, and a lot of other content. Sky's the limit. You can generate full stories or articles or other content by providing some topic or concepts, and ChatGPT would fill the rest in. Or provide a subset of a storyline and ask ChatGPT to expand to full article. You can develop character profiles or even ask for ideas about the story having characters of such and such attributes. ChatGPT is an excellent brainstorming tool and can assist you with generated text fitting your requirements. A suitable process can be to come up with the story title, and then ask ChatGPT to write a preface and chapter titles for the story. Then expand on these chapters by setting the tone and flow of the story. For example, the first chapter can be for the setting and introduction of the characters. The second chapter can introduce a problem or villain. Chapter 3 can be dedicated to the contest between characters and villain. And chapter 4 can be the climax. You can add further details like chapter 3 need to be suspenseful and eventful contests, etc. With countless stories in its training set, ChatGPT would fill in the gaps, or let's say vacuum with awesome content. Generative AI is not restricted to stories, emails, or articles. Its use cases span a lot of industries like art, script writing, software development, healthcare, finance, sales and marketing, etc. ChatGPT has superb code generation capabilities built in, where it can generate software code on demand. This feature and many others have been covered in other videos in this series, so I'll just list them here. Just note that you have total control of the structure, flow, length, breakdown, and format of the content that you generate. You can even generate content in style of some other person, a capability again covered in a specific video in the series. The key is coming up with a proper set of instructions and optionally include example content so that ChatGPT knows exactly what kind of output you have in mind. This concludes our discussion on generative capabilities of ChatGPT. The video just introduced the feature to you and gave you some tips on how to generate content using ChatGPT. There really is no limit to what kind of content can be produced with its help, but I hope you get the general idea and can use these techniques in your specific use case. If you enjoyed it, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to be notified of new content. Thank you.